The DR Congo is the second largest country in Africa and home to a deadly decades-long conflict which has killed millions and forced millions more to flee their homes. Attacks are nothing new, but they're seemingly becoming more frequent. These attacks are linked to a multitude of rebel groups with historic connections to DRC's neighbouring countries, Rwanda, Burundi, and Uganda. As a result, thousands of protesters in the DRC have been calling for the government to sever diplomatic relations with Rwanda, despite peace talks to ease ongoing diplomatic tensions. So, what's causing the crisis in the DRC? Well, the honest answer is, it's complicated. Mineral-rich eastern regions like Ituri, South and North Kivu, and Maniema produce global supplies of cobalt, the metal used in batteries which power our tech devices. The area also has deposits of titanium, copper, diamonds, and gold. For more than 30 years, this area has been at the center of proxy wars and violent exploitation. In early 2022, Belgian gold dealer Alan Goetz was sanctioned by the United States government for allegedly smuggling hundreds of millions of dollars worth of gold from the DRC. The US said the illicit movement of gold provides revenue to armed groups that threaten the peace, security, and stability of the DRC. Alan Goetz denied the allegations against him, but a battle for the nation's vast mineral wealth is not the only factor at play. Armed groups, which are in the hundreds, also play a role in the destabilization. Violence by armed groups is worsened by ethnic divisions in a country with more than 200 tribes. Who is being impacted?
Lorsqu'ils vont payer les gens qui sont morts ici, qui vont les payer? Qui va nous aider?
It's often civilians who are impacted the most. In May of 2022, nearly 100 people were killed in a string of brutal attacks. Victims included young children. Later that month, officials found 17 decomposing bodies by a riverbed in Ituri, some having been decapitated. It's estimated that 6 million people have been killed in this ongoing conflict and many more have fled. Who are the key players? Countries in the Great Lakes have frequently traded accusations of plots to destabilize one another by using the many rebel groups operating in the region. The relationship between Rwanda and the DR Congo has especially got tense. The head of the African Union, Macky Sall, has called on the two countries to pursue peace. What's being done about it? Persistent death and destruction has made Congolese nationals hostile towards intervention by their neighbours, making longer-term stability difficult. But some things are being done. In 2021, President Felix Tshisekedi imposed military rule in North Kivu and Ituri provinces, but that's done little to ease the unrest. Uganda and the DRC are currently on a joint military operation against the ADF rebel group. This is the largest foreign intervention in DRC by any organization other than the UN. Shortly after joining the East African Community in April 2022, President Tshisekedi asked for intervention from member states over DR Congo's security crisis. Kenya offered to host peace talks between rebels and Congolese officials. Attempts to get rebel groups to join ceasefire talks have faced setbacks. Mistrust among some of the regional leaders hasn't helped matters either. At a meeting in Kenya in June, there was some disagreement about deploying a joint regional force. So it's fair to say that most people, if not everybody, wants to see an end to this conflict. But with tensions so deeply embedded into the DNA of the country, it's difficult to predict when a resolution to DRC's problems will come.